సైరామ్ అంటే
Nice, Vidya. Nice to see you. Nice to meet you. I have a daughter by name Vidya also.
Yes.
One more daughter, rather.
Yes. We will begin with three omkars, introduction, and then we will commence our satsang today. ईश्वराय विद्महे सत्यदेवाय धीमहि तन्नः सर्वः प्रचोदयात्। ॐ ईश्वराय विद्महे सत्यदेवाय धीमहि तन्नः सर्वः प्रचोदयात्। ॐ ईश्वराय विद्महे सत्यदेवाय धीमहि तन्नः सर्वः प्रचोदयात्। शांति शांति शांति। ओम श्री साई राम। हम्बल प्रणाम्स एट द लोटस फीट ऑफ आवर बिलोवड मास्टर भगवान श्री सत्य साई बाबा। इट्स अवर ग्रेट प्रिविलेज दैट वी एट श्री सत्य साई सेवा ऑर्गेनाइजेशन नवी मुंबई डिस्ट्रिक्ट हैव द प्रिविलेज ऑफ होस्टिंग ए सत्संग प्रेम प्रभाव फ्रॉम Dr. Kamakshi Kannan, an epitome of service. In fact, she's so humble that if we utter the word epitome of service, she says it's all dedicated to the Lord. So it's all to the Lord and not to her. Dr. Kamakshi Kannan graduated from Bangalore Medical College in 1973 and did further specialization in pediatrics. She had a brief stint in the central and other state government hospitals. And then she was abroad also for some time. And in 1991, with Swami's immense blessings, she joined the Sri Satya Sai General Hospital as a pediatrician and sonologist. She has trained herself in sonology as well. She has witnessed innumerable, you know, firsthand experiences, medical miracles, you know, she has witnessed firsthand where it proved the point that we are all instruments. Only Swami is performing all the, you know, treatments and the, you know, surgeries, everything. Swami is at work. She hails from a family which has been associated with Swami for more than 5 decades now. Her father was an exemplary devotee of Swami, very close to Swami, Sri Tyagarajan. Popularly associated with Sanatan Sarthi and had worked in canteen as well, done seva in canteen as well. Brother Dr. Ravi Kumar from the university, Sister Vasanta Lakshmi from the Sri Satya Sai Primary School, and Sister Bharati Hariharan in the library. All of them have wonderful experiences with Swami and they are immensely blessed by Swami. So let us listen to our dear Dr. Kamakshi Kannan about her experiences and her maxim, love all, serve all, help ever, hurt never. That has been a simple motto of her in life. Sai Ram, over to you, Doctor.
Humble pranams at the lotus feet of Mother Sai. Thank you, Mr. Srinivasan, for the nice introduction. I started believing all these are true, you know, not nice things said about me are really true. I was just wondering, you know, old wine and new bottle, Marie, how can I put different words for the same theory, same fact? So as I was looking, suddenly I realized the program is Sai Pravaha. So I said, well, let us start from the Pravaha. Pravaham of love, isn't it? All of us are immersed in that. We are fortunate to be immersed in that. It is a ceaseless flow of love from Swami. And that's what it does not, you know, limit itself to people who believe or don't believe, or people who know him or does not know him. We have seen by his grace so many things happening which showed Swami's love. So a few, I'll start with a few quotations, few instances. I believe in one of the world conferences on Professor Ramaswamy, who's known as the cart man, you know, who from IIM Bangalore was invited as a guest, and he did not know Swami. So Swami asked him, what do you want? He said, I want to make a phone call. So what did Swami do? He dialed the number. He asked for the number, dialed the number and gave. See the love of Swami, you know. If I told you, you know, what do you want? You say something like that. I say, I am here. I am so great. I could have given you so many things. And so that is the love of Swami. Then a lady was holding a child. Swami came and stood in front of her to give Pada Namaskaram. She was in a dilemma. The child is on the lap. How do I bend to take? It will fall down. So she took the child and gave it in Swami's hand. See how lucky the child is. Swami held the child for a while she took the Pada Namaskar. My father used to be, as I said before also, my father used to be typing the bylaws. He was here because Sanatan Sarthi used to be printed in Bangalore before in the press called the Vraj Brindavan Press, owned by Mrs. Ratanlal or Mr. Ratanlal. So my father used to be in the press, so he was in Vrindavan. So he used to sit on a chair and ordinary those typewriter. He used to be typing. Suddenly he felt a hand touching his shoulders. And when we looked back, it was Swami standing there. So he immediately was to get up. My father was not a very healthy man. So while he was trying to get up to stand, Swami said, "Illa ukkarungo, ukkarungo, sit down, sit down." And then he lifted his foot and put it on the chair for Swami, for my father to take a namaskaram. Such is the love of Swami. Day in and day out, even today, you see, we feel the love and we see his love on other people also. So, as usual, there are people who might not know how we went to Swami. Swami attracts us in various ways. Most of us are selfish. We go for something, you know, from him. Or people just go like that because they are forced to go. So here, both the things happened in our case. Because I went to him first in 67 when I was doing my first year MBBS. Because at the time, the doctors had said my father would live only for a few days or maybe weeks or a month or so. So a friend of mine told me that let us go to Sai Baba in Whitefield. We are anyway already in Bangalore. So she said, let us go because he can help you. So I went to him with a wand. And of course, just sitting there, old mandir, broken wall. The compound wall was broken. Such was the simplicity of Swami then. We were sitting outside. I was sitting outside with my friend, and Swami came out of his room. Just one look, and then your hair is standing on the end. And I mean, we have not seen God, but at the moment, what occurred to me was, this is God. After all, none of us know who is God, isn't it? Even the doctors like us, some people say, you are God. So when the real God comes, we don't know who he is looking. So, but at that juncture, I felt, here is God. So I came home very late to joint family, everybody waiting to pounce and saying, what happened? Why are you late? So I went to my father, who had just come out of a surgery, and told him that, Appa, na Whitefield poirne. Sorry, some are in Tamil, but I'll translate for you. Whitefield poirne, Sai Baba paakkaradhukku. Of course, we knew of his existence. We had not personally gone. Of course, he took us over much earlier than that. So we went, I said, Pa, the Swami Dampa, like that. I told my father, I went to Whitefield to see Sai Baba, and he is God himself. My father was already in agony, and then I came late. He had to answer the worries of his brothers and his father and everyone. They were worried. So they said, Enga poita, and the vice, usually, you know, they were worried. So she said, how come she's late today? There's no way we could convey that. There were no phones, nothing. The whole layout where we say Cambridge layout, there were two houses which had phone. There were two or three houses which had ambassador cars. So those were the days. So I told him, so he said, what do you know? All devoted to God in various forms. But then he said, I said, Illapa, you must go and see him. And he said, okay, let us see. Because he was in agony, he was in a lot of pain. Mostly caused by the doctors, mostly caused by the treatment more than the disease. So, I mean, it happens often, you know. So, the very next day, my father used to go to his office in Tumku Road. Is a very far off place from where we stay. Office bus was not yet there, so he had to take 2-3 buses and go there. But he had decided that till I can go, till the last minute, if I can work, I will work, because we needed that money at home. So he went to the office, and his boss called him and said, Tyagaraj, somebody has come from Delhi, some director or someone, and he wants to visit some Sai Baba in Whitefield. This is the very next day, imagine. He said that, will you go with him, because my wife has some other plan. So if I don't go with her, she will be mad. So why don't you go with him? See how Swami calls us, you know. So I went for the need of saving my father. My father went because he was compelled to go there. Right? So the boss said, you know, as a perk, you will be dropped home. It's an office car. They will drop you home. That was the biggest perk, because it was otherwise agony for him to travel in buses. So thus he went. And my father used to say that as he entered the great gates of Vrindavan, Swami was going back into his gates. So my father thought, I'm an unlucky fellow. People say, here's Sai Baba who can save you, but then he's also, you know, is not saving, he's not there, he's not showing his compassion on me. So they anyway decided to stay for a while there, having gone. So they sat down under a tree, you know, the old Vrindavan, I don't know how many of you have seen, there used to be that Sai Ram shed. And then a lot of trees there, so you could sit where you want. And when we went those days, only two lines, on one line on either side of the gate, and Swami comes out. That's all, a line of maybe 30 people on each side, or totally maybe 100 people most of the days. So that was so great, you can imagine. Swami used to walk out and then go to the other end to the house there where he used to have his tea and or whatever he had for his snacks. He used to go there to eat there. He used to go there. So as my father and this director were sitting under the tree, suddenly the gates opened. One Swami goes in, he doesn't come out generally. He does not come out. So he came and he kept mumbling something as he neared these two people. So they wondered what is, my father was thinking he must be talking to the other gentleman because he knows him. And it can't be to me because I'm coming for the first time. But then he heard, Ennamma Tyagaraju. Appa, he used to say Tyagaraju. So he said that, then my father became alert and said, oh yes, he is talking to me. And he said, no, cancer, Ms. Sonala, this all that is said in Tamil. Tyagaraj, did they say cancer? I will cancel your cancer. And he said, so many surgeries they did on you. I will cancel your cancer. Cancel your cancer. Now, that is it. And then both of us naturally went. And all the credit goes to my father because he became a very staunch devotee of Swami. Now, much before this, this was in 67. I mean, 63, my father, mother passed away on September 15th. My mother passed away. I was 14 and my brother was in fifth year. He was awaiting his birthday. October is his birthday. So he was waiting. My mother was also waiting because he's the only son. And I mean, not that he didn't, she didn't like us, but naturally she liked him more being the only son. So they were waiting and that's the time she passed away. So one of the cousins told my brother that he didn't understand. He was a small child. He was very happy. People decorated her with so much flowers and then they put a red sari on her and all that. Poor child. He didn't realize what happened. Then he was very happy. Oh, so much they are doing for my mother. Then one of the cousins enlightened him saying that your mother is not going to come back. And that's when he became inconsolable. And across the house was my mother's cousin. Mr. Kalyan. I remember them all with gratitude now. So my aunt, Kannamma auntie, took us to her house, said, come there and have something to eat. So four of us went there, three of us, sisters and my brother were taken there. That's where we saw Swami. This is in 63. And I asked my aunt, you know, how come you have this lady's photo? So then she said, ayyo, idu lady illama. It is Swami. Then she said, this is Sai Baba. I will take you. He is in a place called Puttaparthi. He said that he will perform the thread ceremony of my sons. So I will take you all. So anyway, we did not go with her. She was a great devotee. So this, we had forgotten, you know, of course I remembered, but my brother and all didn't remember. Much later, Swami reminded in a speech in Kodaikanal, Swami mentioned that from 1963, they have been coming to me. So my brother thought that maybe he doesn't remember the dates. How can it be 63? Because 67 is when we went. So he tried to remind Swami. And those days, we had the audacity to talk to Swami like that. Said, Swami, no, Swami, we came in 67. Swami said, Illada, don't you remember when your mother passed away in 63? From that time, I have taken over. So when the worldly mother left, the divine mother took over. And he has subsequently also several times told another, one of the boys lost his mother. His name is also Ravi Kumar, V. Ravi Kumar. He was one of the singers there. So to him also, Swami has said that I will take care of you. Ask this Ravi. He used to call my brother Alsur Ravi because we come from this area called Alsur. So I said, ask also Ravi, Ravi, don't I take care of you well? He asked, am I not taking care of you? Then that's the way Swami took us over. And kindness that he has showered on us, we cannot count, we cannot even, I mean, as we keep thinking, it pours in, you know. So Swami, my father used to have a lot of complications because of the surgeries he underwent. And then somehow he, my brother used to be studying in Anantapur at the time. So once he asked my brother, have you seen your father? He said, no, Swami, he hasn't come. He said, no, da, your father has come. He's running temperature. Those days, if the crowd is more towards birthday time and all, they used to have tents at the back. So he's in the tent. Go and bring him and keep him with you in your hostel. So when my brother went and looked, he saw my father who was shivering with temperature. So Swami has been pouring his love on us, just like he has been pouring his love on everybody else in the world. So everything we have, after all, is given by Swami and nothing is ours. So the journey continued. The father once... Those days also, we knew Swami. Some bhajans used to go on in the Talsur Samiti. But our house, we never used to go outside to do bhajans. So my father used to say, why do you want to go there? I sit at home and do bhajans. Because we were excited by the sound of those talam and all that. That's what attracted us to that place. So we used to sit there. But the same place, my father to see my father, we had to go to that place first, because from the office he will go directly to the Alsur Samiti. He was then become, he was the secretary there. They used to call him secretary, sir. So once he was coming from Whitefield, you know, on Fridays, the bhajans there, weekly bhajans. So he had to come there and take the aarti, then only the bhajans will go on. So he could not get the proper bus. He came halfway and he was wondering, how do I reach before 6:30? Then an auto rickshaw fellow came and told him, get in. And he said, where do you want to go? Hindi la, kahan jana hai? So my father said, and Ramakrishna Math pon also. So he said, just sit down. And I believe there was only hardly five minutes or 10 minutes. My father said, anyway, I cannot make it. So he took him there. And as he got down, asked, how much should I pay you? He said, I don't want to take money from you. My father said, no, I must pay you. He said, nahin, nahin, koi parwa nahin, nahin chahiye. My father just asked him, what's your name? He said, Baba. So he said, yeah, he looks like a Muslim fellow. So maybe some Baba he is. And then went in exactly at the stroke of 6:30 when the bhajans were to begin and people were happy. Secretary sir came in time. So as he was taking the aarti, Swami asked him from the photo that how was the auto ride. So my father thought maybe, you know, maybe because all the time I was thinking of reaching here, that must be the illusion I've got. But the next day when he came to Whitefield and sat there, Swami came to him, Tyagaraj, na auto nanna otrena, do I, am I a good auto rickshaw driver? He asked him. That is when it struck my father that he was the auto rickshaw, Sanatana Sarathi was the auto rickshaw driver there. So several of these instances, you know, Swami has been there. But then Swami's shower of love is always there. But reciprocation also should be there from us. If you have complete faith and leave everything to him, you know, things go on all right. So while my father was coming from there once, I believe they just crossed the railway crossing near Vrindavan and then he jumped out of the bus. So everybody scolded him. He said, old man, why do you want to do this and all? And the next day, the other staff came with plasters over them in various parts of the body. And then they asked Tyagaraj, sir, how did you jump out of the bus? Why did you jump out of the bus? He said, Swami told me to jump out. So I jumped out. So all this I am talking more about my father because it is because of him we are with Swami today. Even my brother, he used to be reluctant to go for bhajans. He was a small child, you see, 6-7 years. Now that time, maybe 8-9 years old. He will be standing up and my father will say, Ravi, Varialia. He will tell us, I don't want to go. And then my father will call him, will you come? Immediately, varempa, he will run down. And it is those, you know, which have brought him so close to Swami in the subsequent years and keeps him there. So it is, that is why for me, the first hero is my father. My father was our mother also. He took care of us so much. We lost him in 2006. In a grand way, he left the world and joined Swami. So his exit also was a wonderful thing. In the meantime, many times he was sick. One of the instances, he had a paralysis and he lost his speech. Swami had blessed him with an extrasensory perception. You know, he could just look at people and say everything about them. Just unknown people, anybody at all, you know, see, he could tell so many things about them. He could tell them about what's happening in their family, who their neighbors are, everything he used to tell. So one day somebody brought a young girl, teenage girl who was paralyzed and lower limbs were paralyzed below the hip from Hyderabad. They were old devotees, I believe. So they were sitting for Swami's to give a letter and Swami's blessing, but Swami did not see them. They felt Swami did not see them. So they brought her, carried her up second floor. Puttaparthi, usually older people are above, so that they can go faster. So the younger people stay down, older people are in the second floor. And so they carried this girl and went to my father. My father said, it's foolish to go to anybody else when God himself is there. But the next day, sitting in the darshan line, he was thinking of the girl and he was praying. Then Swami came there and said, hey Ganesha, yaar ku recommend pandra? Whom are you recommending? So then subsequently, after a couple of months, they wrote to my father saying the girl had completely recovered. My father could sit in one place and visualize the Ganeshas all over the world. He would explain a Ganesha temple in a place which he has never seen before. So that is the... Then I asked, my father retired. He was employed there by Swami. He got to do service there in the press first, and then later on he was working in the canteen. And in 76, Swami performed the threat ceremony of my brother, in which he promised that he will find a groom for my sister, who is a librarian. But in 76 was the wedding. And this is another fantastic occasion where Swami showered his love on our family. Everything was fixed by Swami. Though a couple of horoscopes were shown to him, he chose one saying that this boy is in Bangalore and he is right now serving in Vrindavan only. He was a sevadal. So he will be suitable because your daughter will be near you. So chose him and chose everything. And when the date was fixed, and my brothers gave the invitation to Swami because my father was held up or sick or something. Swami said, oh, that date I have got a meeting in Bangalore. So first Swami had said, we will keep it in Puttaparthi because you have a lot of people in Bangalore. So it will be difficult to manage for you. So then Swami said, no, we'll keep it in Bangalore. From the menu to the kolam, rangoli to the decorations, Swami took personal care. Everything he looked into, I believe, when they were even putting the rangoli, he came down and saw to it. He was watching that. So when the time came for giving the girl away, Swami got up and said that this child doesn't have a mother. So I will do the kanyadanam. And Swami stayed for 1 hour in the wedding. Unfortunately, I was not there. I just come and gone. So I was not a witness to this. Swami was there. Then Mr. V.K. Narasimhan uncle asked Swami, how come, you know, in this wedding, you stayed for one whole hour. Normally you come for a while and then after Mangalyadanam, you go away. He said, these children consider me their father and mother. So because of their faith, I was there today. So he took care and performed the wedding, created a Tirumangalyam for her and took care and advised them. Swami is always never partial to one. So he will always tell the groom, you know, you be nice to her and tell the girl also, you also better adjust and be happy. So anusariche anandama irungo, he said. Adjust and be happy is the blessing he gave to them. And then, so it went on. So many, once in Kodaikanal, Swami was talking about our family. When he mentioned about all our other uncles, ours was a joint family at the time. Now I was thinking the other day, even after Swami, you know, we visited Swami and my father was saved and all that. For many days, Swami was still in the front room where I'm sitting. It was the same house then also. And I remember it as a calendar which was hanging near the window here. Swami had not reached our puja room, which had 100 photos and 1,000 cockroaches. Maybe because of that, he didn't go there yet. So he was here and every day we used to have dust on that. You know, those days vehicles were not much, so not much dust used to be there. But the photo used to be full of dust and every day we used to wipe it and say, Patalo, re dust ark, you know, it's always filled with dust. Later on we bought went to Puttaparthi and bought one Bhajanavali book. And when we came home in a few days, we realized that there were lumps of vibhuti in the book. So that is when we realized even on the photo there, it was vibhuti and we thought it was dust and we were really meticulously wiping it away. Such were our ignorance, but he didn't let go of our hand. See, he continued. It doesn't make a difference to him, you know, whether you praise him or you don't. So I was talking to my other people that day, and I asked him, when did we keep Swami's photo in the puja room? Because naturally everybody used to do puja, and there used to be a separate room, and so many photos were there. I mean, many gods also, we don't know which kovil and all that, which temple god, but it used to be there. As I said, 100 photos and 1,000 cockroaches behind them. So many were there, but Swami's photo didn't go there yet. So I remember this photo, and then in 68 or so, the friend of mine who took me to Swami, she had given me two photos of Swami, you know, one in which he is sitting in that nice chair of his, and in the other one, he is just lying down on on his sofa, like that. So those are the two photos we got, black and white photos initially. Subsequently, a lot of photos are there. But till today, I don't remember when exactly Swami entered our puja room. Does not matter to him at all, you know, whether you do puja to him or not, it does not matter. So we went on, and then my brother joined the college. He studied there. Each one has their own experience. It's better in their own tongue always. So I got into a family where my husband was the only son with three sisters. Excellent people, but they did not know Swami. So convincing my husband to come to Whitefield used to be very difficult. So I have to tell him, you know, time at the let's go. And then on scooter, we had to come from far off. Jayanagar to Whitefield was a long distance. But most of the time, by the time we reach there, Swami will be going back. So still, it does not matter. Because when my husband died in 95, Swami gave an interview. I would like to talk about this to just tell you how much care Swami took. My husband was going to Puttaparthi. My children were studying there. He was going there to meet my two children who were in the hostel. And then my elder son, daughter, and my nephew were with him. They met with an accident on the way to Parthi, and he passed away on the spot, they say. So that's one thing. It's okay, he passed away. Then after 15 days, of course, the amount of help we got at that time is something fantastic, because these were children. All three were children. My son was in his third semester, fourth semester of engineering. My nephew was doing his engineering, this one, and REC he was studying. My sister was in Parthi, her son. My daughter was in PUC here. So these three people, they didn't know he passed away. Police car which went by saw and said, oh, spot. And then they took my daughter and, they went in the police car, they took her to Puttaparthi and left her in the mandir. But this I am telling, the grief of losing husband is one thing, but the glory of God is what I am trying to say. So some other car came and took them and to the hospital, and then because he was dead, so they couldn't do anything. I wasn't with them at the time. So then the jeep in which they had gone had fallen down. The next day, the case had to be, they did not know. So my children brought the body back to Bangalore because they did not know anything. They are children. Somebody who was in a taxi, they gave the taxi to them. They said, take the taxi and go to the hospital. Hospital, they said, he is not there. And they didn't do anything. They didn't do certification or anything. And so they brought him off like that, thinking that let's go to Bangalore, you know. Our phone and all were not there. They just sent words with somebody to my sister. No, my daughter went there. So these people came back and kept him in on Baptist Hospital. Now this Baptist Hospital is about, about 10, 12 kilometers from here. And just out of the blue, sometime before that, one of the doctors told me, ma'am, the pediatrician is not there. Could you cover? Because, whenever somebody goes, only one pediatrician has gone to do his specialization. So can you cover there? Now, this was something far away. And I just to oblige them, I said, okay. But then most of the time when they called me was when they had to certify a child who was going. Because the postgraduates cannot certify according to those days law. So I told the management that it's not serving any purpose, because somebody is very sick, then you send an ambulance, then I come from here And most of the time I'm certifying, so please find somebody who can stay with you. Or so I left the hospital. So after this, a couple of years later is when my husband passed away. So children knew that hospital, so they brought him there. And in the meantime, I came to know there was an accident. And they were trying to tell me he's not there, but I asked, is he alive or dead? That's the first question I asked. Later on, Mr. Narasimhamurthy sir was here as the warden. He's the one who conveyed the news to me. But he didn't want to tell me directly. They could have told me, but they said, no, you know, Mr. Kannan is very seriously hurt and all that. I said, it's okay, sir. He's alive, no, so don't worry about it. So I arranged, he was AB. So I arranged for a blood group with one of my cousins. I said, Sandhya, come, Mattimber has got hurt. Come with me, let us go. Then by the time the others knew that he was not there. So the hospital, I'm explaining it so much only to show the amount of love people associated with Swami also shower on you. You know, the amount of help you get when you know Swami. So they were all here, and that's when I realized, okay, maybe something is wrong. So one of the IGs had, he told, Madam, you can go to the hospital in the morning. My husband's body was brought to this Baptist hospital because my children knew I used to go there. But by then I had stopped working there. So everything in life has a purpose, you know. So when these people came there, they were feeling very bad because they knew me and their casualty had only 4 beds. So they called to tell me, ma'am, they have brought him dead. But sorry, madam, we can't keep him for very long. I didn't understand at the time. What they meant was they had to shift him to mortuary. Later I said, no, don't worry. He's not there, so it's not going to affect him. So you shift him. The next day, IG police, Mr. SNS Murthy, so he had ascertained one ACP to me and he said, madam, you go there and they will come and help you. Can you believe, you know, I am from a very conservative family, never gone out even after marrying and all. I didn't know how to even fill a challan in the bank and all that because there was no need. You see, my husband used to do everything and before that we never had money to fill a challan. So necessity was not there at all. So I went there and even recently also talking to some other doctors, they were telling, I don't know how you were behaving like that. There's no other go, you see. There was nobody. Even in our family, we were the ones they were looking up to. And then when in trouble, you see, who is there to come up? Because they were all broken, you see. My uncles and all were so much upset and they didn't know anything. At least I am a doctor. I knew the procedure. So I wrote a letter. See, my son was driving at the time. And they skidded on the road and then the car, catapulted like that. And then whatever, he passed away. The others, nobody had any, literally no injuries to anybody else. So his time has come and that's the thing. Then anyway, so I wrote a letter to the police saying that please release the body for postmortem. They have to release. So then the ACP came. He told me, madam, what have you written? I had not mentioned my son's name. I said, on the way to Parthi, this is what happened. So he said, tear the letter and throw it. And he said, at the time of accident, Mr. Kannan was driving the car. Because see the implications, you know. They would have arrested my son. Because subsequently also, they said something golmaal is there. Because this is, my children didn't realize they were crossing the border. From Andhra to Karnataka, they had come away. Anyway, all this was done and they had to transfer the case to Andhra. So my brother and another colleague, Mr. Nandagopal, I tell you, I'm so grateful to all these children of Swami. So much help on that day. I might have slept a wink, but not these children of Sai who came to be with me. So they went along with my son and then the ACP called me and said, madam, I'm sending a constable. Let them be quiet, not talk too much because Andhra police are very rough. And this accident case, they can, you know, they can cause a lot of trouble. At the same time, another, the IG police had come, Mr. V.V. Bhaskar, great devotee of Swami. They had come to see my father for condolence. So he saw me. He said, "Very sorry, doctor. Such a thing happened and all that." I said, "Just now they have gone, sir, with Ravi. They knew my brother." I said, "They have gone to Andhra, and just now ACP sir said it was tough." He said, "No, no. Why will they be tough to you?" So he called them up. I believe when these people went, Varavakondar, one of those places, police constable said, "Ah, accident. You people there, I am sure, you see, there must be something wrong. That's why you're trying to hide." Am I in screen or? Anyway, so he said that you people, there must be something, some foul play. Anyway, wait there, and he went away. And these people were sitting, no tea, no water, nothing. From morning, they were sitting till 3 o'clock. And then suddenly the same policeman comes saying, "Sairam sir, sorry, there was another accident. So we got involved there and it became late, and he made them have tea there and wrote a letter for releasing the vehicle." Such was the amount of help we received at the time. And throughout people helped us. So after 15 days, we went to see Swami. Swami gave us an interview at the time, and he asked me what happened. He was speaking to us in Tamil. He said, "What happened? Please let me know if it is time, because I am not watching the time." Okay. So Swami said, "What happened?" I said, "Swami, you know everything." Because then he said, "Avarku time aayiduthu, adhanaala enna vandu senduttaar." And he did this. I said, "Avadarame vandu poyindruka." His time is over. He came and joined me. And he said, "Avataras themselves come and go." Just imagine, we are a nobody, you see, to ourselves, but not to the Lord. He is the mother. He loves everyone. What was the need to tell avadarame vandu poyindruka? He need not equate himself with an ordinary soul. And then I told him, if he has come and joined you, our vandu sendutar, he said. I said, "Vandu sendutar, adha kuda enna venum Swami," like that. So in the previous years, many, when my father was still a new devotee, one day Swami came and told him, suddenly he said, "Tyagamu illa, rajyamu illa, enna tyagaraju?" He had told him at that time. Now this is several years later. And then I said, "Swami, if he has come and joined you, what more can we ask for? It is all right, his time is over." Then again he said, his time is over. He came and joined me. Avadarame vandu poyindruka. So I was very moved, you know. He said, "Na onniyum ungalaiyum unga kuzhandhaiyum na paathukuren." Avaru ungalandhan solluvar, nariya time pesircha ungalandhan solluvar. I will again come back to that. Then I said, "It's okay, Swami. Anyway, he has come and joined you." He said, "Yeah, ungalku paravaalla. Yena," then told my others, my sisters and all, "that ivalku nariya Swami mele devotion irukku. Adhanaala Swami mele nariya nambikai irukku. Adhanaala dhaan ipdi iruka. Vera yaaravadhu irundha soon aayirpa and the situation. Anybody else would have soon. Only because she trusts Swami, she is like this." And then he said, "What about your father? He has suffered so much. He has had so many ailments and he has suffered a lot. And today he has proved to be Tyagatke Raja." So I told my father, "Appa, you have graduated in Swami's university now." He said, "Rajamo illa, Tyagamo illa." But now he said, "Tyagatke Raja. So you have graduated." And as we were coming out, I told Swami, I mentioned a few names also and told Swami, the whole lot of the Sai family helped me. Otherwise, I couldn't have done anything. They helped me a lot. He said, "Yes, kandipa pannano. Of course, they must help. It is the same family, you know, they all should help." And then he held my left hand with his right hand, and he patted it thrice and he said, "I will take care of you and your children. I promise, I promise, I promise." I was really moved. I said, "Swami, you are the one taking care anyway. What is the need for you to give a promise?" He said, "Illa, naan paathukuren." Then of course, I told him with my hands, "I should be serving the needy, Swami." Then he kept his hand on my head and And then he chanted some mantram, which we didn't know. But the greatest thing was, he said, yeah, you must help. It's the same family, you know. So many times he has always addressed me as Neenga. Neenga enna pandral, Neenga. It was the way he used to talk. So I used to be working honorary in that hospital. I used to initially go twice a week and then more often later. Though they offered me the allowance, you know, for the vehicle allowance, I told them I also work in other places, so I don't want to take from Swami's place. Mm-hmm. But after my husband passed away, that is 4 years after I had joined, 91 I had joined, 95 he passed away, Swami asked the in-charge doctor that, are you paying something to Tyagarajan's daughter? You know, after her husband passed away, she is having trouble financially. So just imagine what compassion, isn't it? Then, of course, they paid me some amount. They asked me if I needed more. I said, no, this is enough. So in those days, in the hospital, there was no payment, you know. Swami was not paying people, as a regular salary system was not there. So in 91, I joined the hospital. 92, during, he had called the doctors, and we were all standing there, and the in-charge doctor Savitri used to be there. She had a bag with her, a plastic bag with her, some covers in that. And later I came to know that Swami used to call her every time he comes to Bangalore, twice a year or something. He used to give the doctors some pocket money, it was called. It was not a salary. So Swami will put money in the cover and keep it. And she will hold on to it, thinking that if Swami, you know, if Swami gives it, then he will stay with us for longer and people can get Padanamskaram also. But that time it was in 92. April 22nd or 23rd, I believe the previous day he asked for the list of the people working there. And after the list was over, he asked anybody else working there. Then she said, this Ravi Kumar's sister is also joined us. She is also working there. He didn't say anything. He just smiled. And the next day, as we were standing there, he brought a cover in his hand. And I didn't know what it was, you know. So then Swami, he asked her, have you given people the covers? She said, not yet, Swami. He said, give it off yourself. And then told me that I have not, in Telugu, he said, veeluku ivvaledu. I have not given her and put it in my hand. I didn't know what it was, you know, because I didn't know Swami was paying them like that. Till very recently, I didn't know what was, I mean, later on, I came to know it was money, but I didn't know how much was there. Recently, the cover tore, you see, the top had torn, so I realized it was 1,000 rupees, 100 rupee notes were there, the old 100 rupee notes are there, which I will pass on to my children, and hopefully the future generations will know the value of that money. So this is the way Swami has been showering his love and affection and compassion on that, on our family. So he does on all the other families too. So this hospital of Swami is something unique, you know. It is a honor to be in any of Swami's institutions. Because, I mean, wherever we work, you see, Akashat Patitam Doyam Yata Gacchati Sagaram Gramari, enga irundalum every service reaches him. But these are unique places where Swami chooses us, you see, so that probably it is because of the punyams of our forefathers, or probably somewhere we have also been good. So we are permitted to stay there. You mean to say this Lord cannot cure the ailment of the world? You think Karuna is anything at all for him? But then he gives a lot of chances for others to serve and attain spiritual heights. So that is how we continue to be there. It's an amazing hospital. The previous old hospital, not the state of the art present one, this, it has got its own glory. Previous hospital in Bangalore, of course, it was the second hospital to be started by Swami. First one was in Puttaparthi General Hospital. Second one was Bangalore General Hospital. This land was given to Swami by a Maharashtrian gentleman, Mr. Ganpolan, who had come from I think Germany. He had land there. So he used to conduct medical camps with two friends of his there, because there was nothing in that white field those days. It was a pensioner's paradise, lovely huge bungalows, with orchards full of guavas and sapota trees were there. So this is the place that, of course, before that, after I finished my house surgency, I worked in Whitefield in another hospital because Swami's hospital was not there. 72, 73, I was there for a few months when I used to cycle up from there to go to see Swami. So on the way, I used to stop at Divine Light Society for the Blind. There is one near that Hope Farm where I used to transcribe books for them into. I used to read out and they used to transcribe it into Braille. I used to cycle up to see Swami. Those were all such great, wonderful days. One look, even when you're far away, you see, satisfied you. Later years, when you came to the first line or special line, is when the disappointments were more. You said, oh, Swami never saw me. I never got Pad Namaskaram. Somebody else got Pad Namaskaram. All this happened in later years. In between, we were in Muscat for a while. My husband was working and I was there. I also worked there for a while. So how Swami responds, you know, when you keep thinking of him. I was thinking there is nothing here. It was in 78 we went to Muscat. So we didn't know anybody who was Swami devotee and all that. So one day as we were thinking in one of the roads where there was a traffic jam unusually, somebody walked across and told us, Sairam doctor, neenga Swami devotee ni yaro sonna. So why don't you join us for bhajans on this? Friday used to be a holiday. It's the holiday in Gulf. So he said, why don't you join? And then subsequently, we started Balvikas in our house. Then other people's children, you know, just gathered them. And whether they knew Swami or not, they were happy to be without the children for a while. So they used to come and sit and I used to teach them some songs and all. So one lot of bachelors used to come who were devoted to Swami. There used to be one Mr. Pandey who was working in Petroleum Development Oman. When we were, say, 30 years or so, he was 50-year-old. So much elderly and much respected. He's a great devotee of Shirdi Baba. He used to converse with Shirdi Baba and Baba used to talk to him from any photo at all. You know, Shiva's photo, Rama's photo, Krishna's photo. He could hear Shirdi Baba's voice and he could converse with him. So we started going here and when I saw those people, I said, you're so devoted to Shirdi Baba, but when he has come back, don't you want to see him again? And then one of the Anantapur girls one day got me the Satyam Sivam Sundaram part 1. And she asked me, auntie, do you have part 4? Because I don't have that part. I said, yeah, I'll get you. This part 1 I had given Mr. Pandey to read. And every week I went, I saw it in the same place. He used to put flowers for every photo. And there was a photo of Swami somebody else had given him. Except Swami's photo, every photo used to have a flower put. So one day as we walked in, he said, Dr. Saab, aapka baba ne kya chamatkar dikhaya aaj? I said, what happened, sir? He said, I will tell you. Bhajan ke baad bataungi. We used to have aartis on Thursday evenings. So after the bhajan, he said that this book has been lying with me from a long time. Yeah, and that day when I entered, I suddenly noticed there was a flower in front of Swami's photo also. I said, okay, something nice. And then he said that he was lying down and he said, let me look at this book because doctor has given and before returning, let me look at the book. So he was perusing and when he was at where Swami was visiting, if Swami was in Himalayas and all, he saw Swami, that photo on which he is sitting on a mule there. You know, all of you must have seen that beautiful photo. So he was looking at that when he suddenly realized the light became very bright. Now, Petroleum Development Oman is one of the most sophisticated areas because petrol and Gulf after all. So it has never happened that there has been a voltage fluctuation there. Then he said, it has never happened in so many years. What happened now today? And then suddenly it became normal and then again the light became brighter. And when he was looking at Swami's photo, he told me that Shirdi Baba's and Swami's photo kept flashing one after another, you know. from the book. So then he said, okay, Manliya karke. He immediately got up and put a flower for Swami. So that is how Swami, for the people who want to come, and a lot of them later on, they were from Andhra and all, but they had not visited Puttaparthi. Some of them became very close to Swami, you know, after that. I used to envy them. I said, I told you to come, look now, you know, I'm sitting where I am and you're so near Swami. So this is Swami's grace. And in Muscat, I mentioned in the last meeting also how Swami has saved us from a very bad accident. You know, if it had happened, I wouldn't be speaking to you today. I was going with my daughter. We always used to play bhajans. Other than that, nothing else, not great, any other exhibition of devotion was there. So we were going in those huge, highways. And I saw a huge container carrier, you know, that huge truck with some, 12 wheels or 16 wheels or something coming. And I saw he's in my path. All along, I said, what a fool, you know, he's in the wrong way. I didn't realize that they had put signs saying, take deviation. And I almost was there, never shifted, though there was place, thinking he's a fool, let him shift. And then I realized I was too close and I couldn't have done anything. In a second, I was on the other side of the truck. So this would have happened only because of Swami. So now the chronology is not there because as I keep telling, some other things are flashing. So after that, we came back here and till then I was only an MBBS. After coming here, I had applied for my specialization, my DCH. And I got it in merit. People didn't believe, you know, because I was 15 years later and still I got in merit. And the day I got my result, somebody told me that Whitefield Hospital, no pediatrician is there. Why don't you come there? So I went there. It's all the timing of Swami. So I joined the hospital then. In the meantime, since I had nothing else to do, I went to watch Sonology. You know, I was fascinated by the software. I was not thinking, you know, not cutting, but yet seeing all the parts from outside without cutting. I was not fascinated. I was fascinated by the measurements. And I said, oh, it's so fantastic. You measure something, it gives the gestational age. And I was fascinated by the software, actually. Then I went on to learn. And soon I started doing ultrasound also. And I can proudly say, by Swami's grace, Bangalore Hospital was the first one to have an ultrasound machine. CTs were also there, but of course, ultrasound was introduced in Bangalore Hospital first, as a result of which I had the honor of scanning many of Swami's family members, including both his sisters. And they were so thrilled, you know, both of them passed away in Bangalore Hospital. Not because of my scanning, much later they passed away. So they used to bring everybody from Patti and say, you know, TV lo chudo. They used to bring, they even brought a girl who was not growing, one of their family members who still comes to see me. They used to say, this girl is not at all growing. Why don't you see in the machine and tell? They thought the machine can, you know, stretch her. She didn't grow. Anyway, so it is thus that we started this. And in this hospital, is something I talk next to my father. I love the hospital the most. Because the Whitefield of those days, this is my 30th year in the hospital. So Whitefield of those days, other than the pensioner's paradise, the villages strewn around were far and there was no way people, they did not have any communication, you know, they could not, and transport, no phones, nothing, no vehicles also. And deliveries have happened in all modes, in auto rickshaws, in the bullock carts. People have come walking all over the hospital, near the gate, near the veranda, in the labor ward, everywhere, because people were coming late and all that. And recently also I was thinking, we have so many complications nowadays. And we do so many investigations. And yet so many things go wrong. Whereas those days, very rarely anything went wrong. Those must be the times when we thought we are treating, you know. The times when something went wrong must be the times the doctors, treating doctors, oh, I can do this, they must have thought. Because every time some complication occurred, we used to shout out to Swami and say, Swami, do something, because we couldn't send the patients to Bangalore. There was no transport available. People didn't have the money to go. So we did not have an ambulance or anything at the time. Very primitive but very efficient healthcare was there. So slowly that hospital developed from mother and child to a general hospital where multi-specialties were developed by the then director, Dr. Balasubramaniam. These names I mentioned because they are all great people who contributed in the Sai's mission there. So he used to bring in a lot of, he's from Jipmer, founder, director of Jipmer. So he used to bring a lot of his students who were super specialists to operate, specialists and super specialists to operate in our hospital. So subsequently, now it has been shifted into the bigger hospital with so much more facilities as a Satya Sai multi-specialty hospital. So this hospital is complete with all levels of treatment, primary, secondary, and tertiary levels of treatment. There are some departments which are not there. And it is such a great place, such a great place. Even wherever Swami's place is, it's like that. You enter this area, as I have said, it is the temple in itself. You don't have to go anywhere else. If you are given an opportunity to serve in Swami's place, you don't need to go to any temple. You don't need to do any yagas, yajnas, nothing. Just serve and see that Swami is happy with what you are doing. And as I said, Swami's ways are very easy. You just have to love all and serve all. Help ever, hurt never. Time and again, he has told that even if you cannot help, it's okay, but don't hurt anybody. It does not matter if you didn't help or because it's not possible all the time. So it was, after all, I feel it's not difficult to follow Swami's path because he has shown us a very easy path to go along with. And I think it's 7 o'clock and I must cut down the narration now. So I've been there till now. A lot of things have happened there. You know, the greatest miracle, it is not the cure of a disease or a dead man walking out and all. They are that such things also happen. When we think this man will not live, he has walked out. There are times when we think this is not a big case, somebody might have gone. This is not, the very miracle is the existence of the place made for the sake of the people who cannot afford outside and for the people like those serving there for their spiritual upliftment. After all, Swami can cure people. It has happened many times. Only one last thing I will tell you, an incident and stop my speech. Once in 2009, Swami was sick. He had a facial palsy at the time. I always used to think in my house, everybody has photo with Swami. When I went to the hospital, everybody individually, they had photos. My brother and all have any number of photos. My sister in school has a lot of photos with Swami. I said, I have come very late. So that opportunity is gone. But then Swami invited, called people inside and called each doctor and whoever had the family to go with. He called them and photos were taken of them. So Swami's love is so wonderful. He bestowed so much benevolence. He said, as soon as he came, he said, 104 temperature, cold water bath, eduthundu vande. I took cold water bath to talk to you all. So much love of Swami, you know, we have felt. Now the miracle, as I tell you, is not the curing of diseases, the very existence of these places are miracles. Now, all these are state of the heart, free hospital. So, with this, thanking Swami and thanking Srinivasan for the opportunity and all of you for the patient listening, Jai Sai Ram. I can go on like this, but maybe another time. Jai Sai Ram and thank you all.
Doctor, it has been a very, very short time in which you have come across so wonderfully well. But we request you to touch upon one or two aspects, which are like, for instance, like the episode of Mr. Sikka's dream. Just touch upon that, which is...
Thank you. I in fact wanted to tell you, let us have an interactive section.
Yes.
But then a lot of people may not know me, so maybe next time, just with the introduction, we'll have an interactive section. That way, a lot of things can come out.
Yeah.
Now, this Mr. Sikka is he's not there anymore. He one of our Samiti members. He was engineer in telephones, and he was the one who put the first telephone in Whitefield and gave the phone to Swami, I believe. That is very, very much devoted to Swami and very fond of singing. He used to be so fond of singing, he will start off in third column. In the meantime, somebody else may start. So in that anxiety to start, he will start off in third column and then come down to the other. So very loving gentleman, and we used to like him, a good friend of my father. So this was the time when my father was to undergo prostate surgery. So Swami had sent words to the doctors there saying, I had not joined the hospital yet. We had just come from abroad. So they told them to arrange for surgery in Whitefield Hospital. Now Whitefield Hospital didn't have a surgery department. They had the OT. They didn't have the surgery department. The departmentalization happened much later. So the few doctors, practically three doctors, I could say, one of which I had the honor of, we used to manage everything, The others were visiting doctors, and we used to be there taking care by Swami's grace. So much was learned just because not many doctors were there. You have to learn. So Swami gave so many opportunities. So Swami had told these doctors, Tyagarajan's surgery, you fix with Dr. H.S. Bhatt. H.S. Bhatt used to be working in St. Philomena's here. And you all must be knowing he joined Swami's hospital later on, super specialty. So they had arranged, but they had no anesthetist. They could not get the anesthetist on that particular day. So Swami, this doctor said, Dr. Rajeshwari was there and another Dr. Savitri was there. So but sir said that send Mr. Tyagarajan to Bangalore only. Anyway, I was there. So send him here. I will operate on him in Philomena's. There Swami, told my brother, when is your dad's surgery? He said, Swami, tomorrow. He said, Yemra, Inka, you're still sitting here. You're not gone, you go. And he created one Kalkand, sugar candy, which my brother eyed eagerly, but he said, that's for your father. So he came to Whitefield, and he found out surgery was not going to be there. The doctors got very scared because Swami had told them to do it there, and they really got very scared. They were different days, I tell you. How much people also cared. Swami, as we have seen him, changed his attitude to suit these people, because there were times when, sorry for digressing like this, but can't help. Swami used to be angry with people because they saw TV when they went on holidays. Isn't it? Subsequently, he adjusted himself to say, at least while eating, don't watch TV. Even that becomes difficult. And even speech and all were originally, later on with the people, Swami brought in a lot of sophistication to suit the public who come there. You see, so like that. So these people were worried about what Swami is going to tell them. Those days Swami will scold them, I told you to operate here, why did you send? So they were worried anyway. So my brother came home, house was fully open, and he tells me only other time house was open was when my mother passed away. Whole thing was open. But our house is, even sometimes I get up in the morning, main door is open, We are used to it like that. God is there protecting us. We are taxing him. So he saw my father come from Shirdi Baba temple is near my house. He saw my father come from there. He said, Appa, ennachi surgery illiya? He said, illada, ni ticket vaangitiya? Because the first thing he said, he wanted to go to Parthi. He said, ticket vaangi vandutiya bus la porthuke? He said, illappa, Swami sent me, gave you the prasadam, and he told that you should you give it to your father. So Appa said, no, Dr. Bhatt took me into the OT, and finally all doctors examine once to be sure the diagnosis. You know, those days hands were the only things. So they examined, even till today, you know, I always use my hand first before doing scan or anything. So he said, he examined him, he said, Tyagaraj, it's like a miracle, you know, I can't feel your prostate. And sent him away. My father came, he went to the temple. As he was coming near home, he saw my brother. And I don't know whether it was from the hospital or it was the next day, I don't remember. And that's all. Now, what happened? 2 days before that, this Mr. Sika came there. And he said, Tyagaraj, you know, yesterday I had a dream. And in that, you are telling that Swami has operated on you. And you are lifting your shirt and your body is full of vibhuti. Your abdomen is full of vibhuti. Anyway, that was before the surgery. So it was over and surgery was not there in any case. So they took the next bus or whatever and they went there. When they went to this one, Prashanti Nilayam, already the veranda was full. So my father sat at the back and Ravi went a little ahead and sat because they have places there. And Swami saw him. Swami was talking to the students and he told him, I believe, Nayana, operation gurinchi cheppu. Tell us about your father's surgery. And he went off inside to give interview. So my brother was thinking, what can I talk about a surgery that didn't happen? So he said, okay, anyway, I have to say something. So he started telling Mr. Sika's story. And then the darshan was over, aarti was over. And then after that, one of the students told, sir, before you came, that is what Swami was talking to us. He said that I myself performed the surgery and walu ollanta vibhuti. Ollanta whole body was filled with vibhuti, Swami told. I mean, can't help, you know, becoming emotional when you think of a God like this. It is amazing. I mean, still it is the tip of the iceberg. What amazing God, amazing. Our contribution is nothing, you see. So my brother-in-law was telling once, my sister's husband, they were going to Swami. He was a youngster and he's very much, how come today in Whitefield so many cars are there? Because the days when people didn't have so many people didn't have cars. So he said, illa perima, adalla, you know, rich people's cars, because he will talk to them. It's not meant for us. Hardly had he finished the sentence, somebody comes running from inside. Swami said that there's a boy wearing blue shirt or whatever. Call him inside. He called him inside and told him, "Na unna paathukuren, nee onnum kavalapadada," and all. Recently, he spoke about all this in our hospital. So Swami, such Swami, you know, everybody is saved to him. He is the mother. So this is Mr. Sika's glory and Swami's glory, of course. It is amazing.
Somebody has posted a question and I'll just pose that question. Before that, in fact, two more small requests have come in before, in fact, which has come to me. Somebody has asked about car breakdown story at Marthahalli Bridge.
Which one, sir?
Car breakdown story at Marthahalli Bridge.
But obviously they have heard it, isn't it? So, I had an Omni at the time. I had an Omni and I claim I am 5 feet. My others say you're not 5 feet, okay? with the smaller cars, when it stops, you know, I was capable of pushing it myself. Believe me, I can push it, jump in, put the third gear and start. That much I had known. Okay, my husband had taught me all that. But Omni, I cannot jump up. So, this Omni stopped at Marthahalli Bridge. One day, Marthahalli Bridge, those days, now it is a wider road, and those days it was a very small road, and Marthahalli is still almost a village only. So it just went up the hill like that and stopped. It wouldn't start. Subsequently, I only found out that from the distributor, you know, the wire was loose and it used to come away. I told the mechanic that the Indian organ, then only, you know, every time I used to touch there and it used to become all right. But this time it didn't. So the car stopped and I was wondering what to do. It was nalla senguthaa irukkira edathula at the peak of the slope it stopped. So I was just looking around, hardly any people around those days, you know, about 25 years ago. ITPL had not started or just started at the time. So it became crowded only after that. It used to be a beautiful avenue of trees from Martha Ali up to Whitefield. That Varthur Kodi used to be tree-lined avenue. So a man came, thin man, not so cleanly dressed. I mean, now I hesitate to say that knowing who it was. But then he was like a laborer, you know, he came and no slippers, nothing. And he had tied his dhoti like kachamichi. He had built it. Many Telugu people wear dhotis like that. And some dirty shirt he was wearing. He asked me what happened. In Telugu, he asked me, Emaindi. I said, the column is going. So he said, sit down. That too, first he said, sit down. Then I was thinking, you know, can he push? I said, shall we ask somebody else? He said, ledu kucho. I thought Andhra fellows are rough, you know, they talk like this. I thought. Anyway, I sat in. And then I was looking at the mirror and he pushed the car with one hand. So it was, I asked him, shall I turn the car so that you come down? And he said, no, kucho. He said. So he pushed the car. Car started and I was scared to, you know, stop because it might go off again. So let me go half a kilometer, run it and then come back. I went and took a U-turn and came back though, about 2-3 kilometers up to HAL Kalyana Mantapam I came. There was nobody on the road, you know. So obviously, what has he not done for us? Isn't it? He drove the auto, he pushed the car and pulled us up many times. So much he has done.
That is the prema pravaha. Yeah, true. Somebody has asked, Doctor, with reference to COVID-19 disease and loneliness, mystery being felt by mankind, can you shed some light on Swami's manner of treating psychological illness, mental health issues that seem to be number one ailment of the lockdown period?
So how do I beat COVID blues? Because keeping myself busy. Okay, I'm 71 year. I'm not 72 year. I'm only 70. So, at least thank God we have work there. So, the only thing we can do is to work. And what you're all doing, you know, so the best opportunity we have got. And, you know, there are a lot of positive things also which have happened. See, COVID is terrible disease because we don't know, you know, whether it will stop at all. But it is not so deadly. It has given an opportunity for introspection. So you, Swami can stop it, any God in any form, if he wanted. First of all, it wouldn't have come, isn't it? So see, this depression and all, of course, they are now clinical matters and proven theories that it does exist and all. But I feel if you cannot control your mind, who else can? So by keeping ourselves busy, and those who can sing, I cannot sing. So I go to the hospital. So those who can serve others in any way like this, organizing things, there are umpteen ways you can help, isn't it? You can provide food for people. There are people who are organizing food. Because one of the fellows, he was telling me that he came out and saw a laborer sitting there and he was sad and crying. He asked him why. He said, "Uta illa, sir, no food." So he went and arranged with a shop that every day, you know, this number of people who come there, you give them food. You give them the rations. So instead of giving him the money. So there are umpteen ways you can keep yourself busy. And after all, it is not the end of the world, right? Things are going on. Even for these people who are having classes and all, they say it's so boring to have online classes. I tell them, look at the positive side of it. You have not lost a year. Your classes are going on. Teachers are struggling more than the students, isn't it? So it is going on. So again, hospitals like ours are still there. Swami's hospital at Puttaparthi is taking all cases. COVID, no COVID, they are treating. In Bangalore, because BBMP, you know, the Bangalore Mahanagar Palika is managing, they take positive cases to other hospitals. Otherwise, so many things are going on. Even today, somebody landed with a heart attack. Nobody asks, are you COVID positive or not? So each one of us have something else to do other than going out, isn't it? What is the restriction now? You have to face the same wife. You have to face the same husband. Same thing, you know. That you have to, you cannot escape from that. So devise ways of, you know, making unpleasantness less. I'm sure happy Swami will be very happy. And those who know Swami, I don't think they will get depressed at all in the first place. Use the time. Only thing is this commuting time and other extra. Otherwise, everybody is working from home. Most of the people are working from home. And the poorer lot have started coming on the street and they are working also. So by spending our time in satsang and spare time, in all these activities, I think you can beat the COVID blues.
Doctor, have you anytime felt that there was a very strong urge within you where you expected something for Swami to give to you and there was a denial? And then later, okay, the situation is corrected.
No, by nature, I feel if Swami has not given, there must be a purpose. So luckily, he has made me like that. Some aberration, you know, it doesn't happen. But there are times, of course, only human, no? So, but then later on, you will always find that it is not the thing. I was amazed that my son was 10 years when his father died. He had got seats in Texas and some other place for his MS. But I did not have money to show. Because I had some shares and by the time they were sold, they wanted money to be shown as, or whatever it is called that you can take out. So by the time I sold, everybody's Jayanti came. From Guru Nanak to Ambedkar to everybody. So banks were closed and I could not show the money in time. But he later told, I said, sorry, da, because of me, you could not go. He said, illama, it's okay. Because at that season, whoever went, you know, there was a slump in the market and they did not get a job.
Okay.
So I thank Swami for the attitude of my children, you see. So otherwise it would have been difficult. They never thought, Amma could not do this or anything. They are grateful to me for whatever I have done. The attitude given by Swami. So we pray for that attitude. Because even in hospital, I always tell them, it doesn't happen. What can you do about it? You would love, to have such a thing the way you want, but it is not possible. So take it like that. And you will realize most of the time it was not the most important thing, isn't it? So we give that importance and later on also we find had it been the way you wanted, it would have been disastrous. So that's it. I have not felt the other way, but I have felt it is okay. It's okay. Nadakala. Carry on. You see, don't live in the past.
Wonderful, Doctor. I think before we just conclude and I summarize, we would like to hear from your beautiful way in which I have heard it at least. And even you could narrate it again. How you really perceive this temple of healing is like Pandharipur. But I have heard it many times and I love the way.
Pandharipur, as such, I have not seen Pandharipur. You are Maharashtrians, you may know Pandharipur.
Yes.
Though I would love to come, I would love to see Pandharipur, just like that. Now you see, wherever you see, you are seeing Swami only. We went to Sringeri, I mean. The four of us and my brother-in-law, after Swami passed away, we said we will go around to some places where Swami has visited. So we went to Hampi, Virupaksha temple, where Swami was seen by his brother. Swami was sitting outside, but his brother saw him there in the idol, Sesham Rajgaru. So he came out to whether this Satya has come running inside or something and found him sitting outside where he was before. So we said, let us go. I told my brother, Vada, we'll go there because Swami was seen by his family in that temple. So we went to Hampi and then we went to Sringeri and Udupi and all those places. It was in Sringeri that I broke down when I saw Swami. But otherwise, wherever you go, every place you don't keep changing the nomenclature. You only say Sairam, whichever God form you see. Isn't it? After a period of time, only his name exists for us. And whatever name you say is also his only, but it's what we are used to. So that's the thing. So in Sringeri, because just then Swami had, it was in May or June or something. Yeah, before the school, college opened. Swami, April he passed away. So it was May end or something we went. So in front of Shardamba, I cried. I said, Swami, why did you leave us? Where do we find you now? You know, we came running to you at all times. After all, we have limitations. He is there. He is listening to us. I will send you, you know, day before yesterday, one of our staff spoke. She's in charge of the dietary. Should see the wonderful way in which there's a lingam inside the hospital Swami's room. The way when she describes an accident in which she was saved, the way in which that flower comes and falls, you know, reassuring. He's sitting and listening, you see. So then we were coming down and suddenly my nephew said, look at that lotus, you know, it is like Swami's symbol. So as we crossed, we saw Sathya Sai School there in Sringeri, that one of those places, maybe some 2-3 kilometers. So I forget the name of the place. So what happened was, I told my brother, come here, let us go and see. It is in Swami's name, so let's go and see. He said, summertime, yaarum irukkamata. I said, never mind, no, we'll go and see. Now you see, when we went in, my brother had not yet taken, just taken over as the warden. Just then, you know, Narasimurthy sir had left and my brother had just become the warden. So we went in and the principal and some teachers were there. So principal told me, madam, I know you because in Bangalore you had scanned me and you said I had fibroid and later on I got operated there itself and all that. And then when she came to know my brother was the warden, they were so moved, you know, then they took us to the conveners, the Samiti conveners house who had also known my family and all. I believe they had given a letter to Swami knowing that Swami is sick, that he should send warden to come and inaugurate their bhajan hall. That bhajan hall was getting ready. She was so moved that warden of Vrindavan they wanted. They didn't mention by name, you know. So we landed there. So Swami says, the minute you think of him, you know, in some form, he says, I am there. So over a period of time, when you start realizing he is there, you know, get over your limitations and see him. Then it is better for all of us.
Thank you so much, Doctor.
Thank you, because
it has been wonderful. It has been really blissful to hear this Netrain experiences of yours, and what a blessed family it has been. And in fact, there has we pray to Swami to have an opportunity that all four of you really get together and, you know, have a conversation which we can listen to. It would be the greatest you know, this thing for us, you know, experience for us.
Today I was telling my brother, sometime let us all sit, because even I went off somewhere and all. Believe me, not even one word I had written down. Normally I write down some points and then I will talk to my sister and ask her, you know, what happened when we had, she has a wonderful memory. My sister was the librarian. So she will say, Lady, apdi sonnar Swami, apdi sonnar and all that. This time, because Hari told me, na jana adhiye dane pa solla poren abdinte. Hari said, paravala, neenga vandu don't prepare nothing, you just go there. Until afternoon, when my brother said he's coming, okay, at least he will talk about Swami, I'll get some points. Till the afternoon he was here, we were talking about Swami, but I had absolutely no idea what I was going to tell you. And even now, I have no idea what I told you. I'll have to listen now. And then suddenly I realized you are talking about, you know, Swami's love and all that. And then I said, okay, excellent, I'll start from there. So he plans, you know, if you leave it to him. So I don't know what I said. I hope it was pleasant for you and for Swami.
In terms of your experience of your father, you know, where Swami canceled the cancer, it was a wonderful episode. In fact,
happened to me also. Maybe some other time I will tell you.
Sure. Some other time, because episode of Swami, you know, auto rickshaw driver. Swami's reciprocation is proportional to our level of surrender. The way you explained it was wonderful. kanyadan for your sister, where Swami was present for 1 hour, that shows the amount of love, in fact, and that kind of, you know, when you completely surrender and take Swami as mother and father, how he takes care. That was really wonderful.
For him to say that, you know.
Exactly. And, you know, he takes care of such small things like, you know, compassion of Swami to give the compensation for hospital duty where he puts something in the envelope and gives it to you. What a gesture, you know.
Imagine. And I was the last person to receive from Swami's hand.
Yeah.
That was the last time he gave, and soon he opened an account for the doctors for that pay. It went from the bank.
Yeah.
So I was the last person and my first thing. And I was not taking money in any case those days. So I had to tell them that give her money because her husband is not there and she is struggling.
Wow.
I have got so much. Sorry, if you keep asking me, there's so much more to tell.
It's okay.
Connected with everything, so I think we will delay others. That's okay.
Definitely it calls for a second session, doctor. Yeah.
Like I was telling you, he used to say, you know, Ninga used to say, Ninga enna pandral, eppadi irukka avanga pulla, appadi mella kepar. So, I mean, if I say, tell you, eppadi irukka avanga pulla na, I know what happened that day when he said that. So I'm thinking, thank you all so much, because we tend to forget what Swami has done for us, you know. We tend to forget so much, so much.
In a remote place like, you know, Muscat, where he showed his omnipresence, you know, with Pandeji's episode.
So many times.
Absolutely wonderful.
So this is one way. Where is your depression in COVID, you tell me? Will you get this much time to talk otherwise?
Very true.
Isn't it? So it should not, we should not have that word depression.
Absolutely true.
So I had an accident where last time I think I mentioned. After that, one Swami had called us to the Kalyan Mandapam in Bangalore, and he was going. So he was on the stage and coming down from there, and we went near him to take Namaskaram. So he looked at me and he said, Vango, you know, he, at the time, he said from above, Budi kaiye kamchi, he said, hey, nee eppadi irukka, he said. I tell you, I was, because till then I used to say, Swami, Ninga Ninga children, am I not close to you? So I said, hey, nee eppadi irukka? That was a year after my accident. So I had broken my leg, you know. So same omni. Then again, how much help came and all, that's another thing. So he, that time Mr. Srinivas was there, Sri Srinivas was there. So he told Swami, Dr. Kamakshi, he does a lot of service for us. And he said, telusu, aite, ee accident jariginaka chala kashtam papam. He said, paavam, inka theriyo, I know. But after the accident, she has a lot of problems, you know. So for him to remember and to mention, I don't think any other Godhead has done that much for humanity, like Swami has done, isn't it? Anyway, let us hope and pray for his continued love.
Doctor, thank you so much.
Prema pravaham.
Yeah, thank you so much. It has been really a flow of love through you. Can I request our district president, Shri Chenuri ji, also to just say a few words, after which we'll close with Samasta Loka Sukhino Bhavantu. Yeah. Chenuri ji.
Yes, my humble pranams at the lotus feet of our living God, and my Sai Ram to all of you. Doctor, you know, it was really a blissful session, you know, how 1.5 hours it went. Really, it was very, very good. You know, one thing you have told that, you know, love all, serve all. Second thing is complete surrender. You know, how Swami saves, really. We are very thankful. And we wanted you to one more to come and, you know, share your experiences. Thank you very much.
Sairam, sir. Thank you so much.
Sairam.
Thank you so much. We will end today's session with 3 Samasta Lokas and Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Om Samasta Loka Sukhino Bhavantu. Samasta Loka Sukhino Bhavantu. Samasta Loka Sukhino Bhavantu. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
बोलो भगवान श्री सत्य साई बाबा जी की जय।
साई राम, we would request all of you to turn on your videos so that we can just have photographs captured and then we'll end the session. Thank you so much, doctor. It has been wonderful.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Veena, could you do that, Sai Ram?
Veena is not there. You can tell Prasanna.
Prasanna?
Yes, yes, Sai Ram. I'll do that.
Yeah. Yeah, please, Sai Ram.
Madam Srinivasan, sir. Hello.
Yeah. Hello.
Srinivasan, sir, can you take a screenshot? Because I'm facing a problem. Yep.
I'll do that. No problem.
இந்த மாதிரி வந்து ஐ மீன் ரைட் ஃப்ரம் த மவுத் என்ன எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸஸ்
ரொம்ப ரொம்ப மெய் சிரிச்சு போச்சு அப்படியே
மெய் சிலித்து போச்சு ஜஸ்ட் டெஃபரட்
थैंक यू நாகேஷ் ஜி थैंक यू
थैंक यू थैंक यू ஸ்ரீனிவாசன்
எக்ஸலென்ட் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் ஐ ஷேர்ட் ஸ்ரீனிவாசன் ஜி
थैंक यू அம்மா ஜி எல்லா சுவாமிதா சுவாமிதா எல்லா சுவாமி த்ரூ தேர் இன்ஸ்ட்ருமென்ட்ஸ்
இன்னும் இன்னொரு நாள் கூப்பிடணும் சார்
definitely we'll call her again doctor swami indrakara appa kattayama we are in the
one more session
this is no more actually this is a satsang not during covid has now become a govind satsang now
so much
la many more sessions like this
yes
we will inspire many more sessions like yes. this sister Guna has been also doing lot of wonderful sessions so we'll continue this journey and we'll have more sessions like this
Sai Ram. Sai Ram. Sai Ram. Sai Ram, I'll end the session.
You can end the session.